So we've just reached a massive milestone. We've just officially finished all the glasswork that needs to be done on the hull. And the boat is now structurally sound. We've taken a bunch of balsa core out. We've probably thrown about 20 gallons of resin at this boat. And it's at the point now where it's all strong, it's all flat, and we're ready to start filling it.
Never knew the day would come.
Big milestone.
That was the hardest thing I think I've ever done. Couldn't sleep.
Having nightmares.
Just nightmares about the next day getting in the suit. But we didn't let it beat us.
Not done yet, but we're getting there.
Yeah, but that bit's done. That's like,
yeah,
it's going to be like a holiday now.
Yeah, it is really tough. The boys are killing it. We reckon we might have another 5 weeks to go, hopefully. And then we're setting sail again, so the good times are on the horizon. And we're taking care of absolutely everything. Every little scratch, every little bit of white fiberglass that's sort of even slightly delaminated, we're grinding it out, and we're doing it all from scratch. So I've always been a perfectionist, and I'm not gonna stop now.
With Hurricane Irma, boats tossed. Here we are at this marina.
Hi, my name's Colin. I used to be a chief engineer on super yachts, but gave it all up to buy a hurricane-damaged Lagoon 450. My friends and I are fixing it up as we go, and are determined to circumnavigate the entire planet. So subscribe if you want some inspiration to live life to the fullest. 20 years from now, you will be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the things you did. So what are you waiting for? So the first thing to do before we started fairing the hull was to grind back all of the new fiberglass to give the filler a better mechanical bond with the glass, so it was straight back into the suits for us. But this didn't take us too long, and we were able to start the fairing process.
So the first thing we're going to do is wipe the whole thing down really well with acetone, and then we're going to mix gel coat with the wax and the catalyst. But first we're going to mix in the cover seal, which is this stuff here. Just a micro balloon filler. So we mix the micro balloons in, get it nice and thick, like a peanut butter sort of a texture. And then we put the wax in, we mix the wax through, and then we put the catalyst in. So the catalyst is at about a 2% ratio. So hopefully by the end of the day, the entire boat has had its first layer of gel coat filler. Here we have Noodles having a crack. Guys, so yesterday, in one day, we managed to get all of the first coat, first layer of filler on the boat. Really happy with it, so we're just going around the boat now and giving it its first sand. We're using 40 grit sandpaper on the longboard, just really cutting into it, knocking out all the high spots, and then finding out where all the low spots are so we can fill it again for the second time. So our friend Dave's got a Fontaine Peugeot, catamaran, and he wants us to help him lift the new hard top that they've made. It's pretty cool what they did. They made a mold over his the roof of his salon, and then they used the mold to make a hard top which exactly matches the roof of his salon. It's massive and it's super heavy. We just tried to lift it and it was just really difficult. Eight guys. So Noodles is a little bit tired of looking a bit soft, and he wants to look hard, he reckons. He wants to look tough, so he's asked us to give him a mohawk. So that's what we're gonna do. Looking tough, brother.
I'm about to look tougher, cuz, once I get the drum out.
Stupid, it looks better.
Nah, I need it to look clean and hard.
Clean and hard?
Yeah, I want to walk in and everyone will see and they'll know that I'm the toughest one there. Directly. That's the goal, isn't it?
Does it?
Does it have to be like a long ass one like that or? Nah, it does, it looks hard.
So I've just gone and picked up Jeremy. He is one of our patrons, and he's been messaging me for a while, just saying that he wants to come and help us out. He knows we're in the shipyard here and stuff. So he's generously come along to help out, and I was trying to figure it all out. Like, why does this guy want to come out? It sounded too good to be true. Like, he's just, I just want to help you. And I was like, yeah, but what are you expecting? And he's like, I just want to help you guys out. He's arrived here with a massive suitcase full of gifts and stuff. He's been watching our episodes and obviously seeing things that we've needed along the way, and just really thoughtfully just bought us a bunch of gifts. So, got a new crew member for a couple of weeks. It's gonna be fun getting to know him.
Information that I've learned is from that man standing right there.
Yeah.
Seriously, just from watching, he puts more information on the sailing part of things than anybody else that does this.
So we've learned so much about this whole filling and fairing process, but luckily we've got some good people informing us and supervising us and helping us all the way along. So the key to the whole thing is to use these longboards and just keep everything super flat. When we're running our hand over it, if we can feel any bit of a hollow or a hump, we're either sanding it or filling it, and it should just be perfectly flat. There's no reason we can't get it like that. The problem with that is that there's just so much to do. So it's taken us probably 2 weeks just to do this filling and fairing process. But like I said, while we're here, we might as well get it right.
It was during this time that we got a visit from Helena, who we met in El Salvador, as you may remember from the last episode. So her, Jeremy and I rented bikes again and explored more of the Guatemalan jungle.
Morning, guys. After weeks and weeks of preparation, what's funny? After weeks and weeks of prep,
We're at the point now where we're kind of putting on the final layer of filler. So we've hired someone to help us for this final touch. He's been great. We're going to mark up the whole boat and then hopefully get a layer of filler on it. And then we'll be sanding that later today. So these are all just slightly low spots. So he's just running his hand over it like that. And when you can feel a slight dip, he's just marking it with a pencil so we know exactly where we need to fill. We've basically done this 4 times now because it's basically how bad we are at doing it. So the local labor here, this guy's actually pretty skilled. He knows what he's doing. And we're only paying him 130 Q a day, which is, I don't know, about $18 per day. So I just thought it's such a cheap, the labor's so cheap that it's just so worth it just to get someone to help us out for a while. And he's making a huge difference. He starts at 7 o'clock and he doesn't stop till 3. Well, yeah, he has a 1 hour lunch break, but he doesn't really stop working at all. He's just a really good, hard-working guy. Really glad to have some help. And skilled help as well, not just unskilled labor. That's one of the best parts about doing work in Guatemala, is how cheap the labor is. So our friend Runners, we call him Runners because he's run aground about 12 times. So he's earned the nickname Runners. He's got a Hunter 34 and he's taking us sailing today. So we're gonna motor up the Rio Dulce. You wanna go sailing?
Call me out, tiger. Call me out, why don't you? Lift me up higher, above the clouds, won't you love? When the scenery is right, go right in. I want to fall deep within.
This is called Texan Bay, apparently. There's a guy here called Texas Mike. Have a drink at his bar and maybe get some food, but it's an awesome little spot.
Welcome to Texan Bay.
You.
Best anchorage.
For some reason, we've decided to do a shotgun here at Texan Bay, so let's do this.
There it goes.
All right.
On the count of three.
Three, oh,
two, two, one, go.
Oh. Get all that?
Not even for love.
We decided there and then that we were not going back to Rio that evening, so the festivities continued long into the night, Guatemalan style. It was a slow start the next morning, but we eventually made it back to Rio Dulce, where we picked up yet another crew member, Matt, from South Africa, who actually sailed into Rio on another boat and decided he'd love to help out with our project. He proved his worth on day one by helping us lug our freshly galvanized chain all the way back to the boat. Parlay just seems to attract these incredible souls, and it is such an honor getting to know these people from all over the world and sharing these experiences with them through both the tough times and the good.
So that's the final product there, brother. Looking slick.
Check out
the shoulders. Did you achieve the tough guy look or what?
Check the shoulders.
Shoulders like boulders.
Yeah.
Look at the facial hair.
That's the one.
Look out.